Welcome to Rate Your Setup, Episode 3. We're already on the third episode, and what started out as a bad video is slowly improving. I'm grateful for that. It's my best friend's favorite show, so definitely it is worth taking your time watching this video. Now, I feel like this is very tiring to say, and that is going over the critiques. So my 7 critiques for the setups is lights, cleanliness, product brand, desk, computer case, hands-on accessories, mouse, and keyboard. That's it. So let's look at the setups that we got today. Friendos, if you're watching this, you're doing great. Like, keep watching my jokes. My great jokes. Like, this whole channel is a joke so far. Except I am taking somewhat of a serious approach. So let's look at our first setup. So I know I haven't been giving enough credits to the people who posted these pictures from where I'm getting the setup photos from, but in the description I will give you the link to where you can find these photos. So they deserve credit. I'm sorry, even though I never got any criticism on. You should probably give credits and mention that. Well, there you go. Credits to gamingsetup.s. Let's look at our first one. First of all, what is this color? Explain to me what this color is. Listen, I respect that you have this blue theme, but you can see the obvious glows. I mean, literally, you see this big window, right? And then you have a shelf right next to the table. I appreciate the desk. I appreciate the keyboard and mouse because I recognize them. Monitor setup, I love it. You know, it's all clean. But why is there a shelf with an LED light strips behind this shelf and it's glowing directly on the window? I'm pointing to my window, which is something that you can't look at right now, but you know, I'm pointing at it. But seriously, no one can see that. You're gonna blind someone outside of your house when they're walking by. It's not like it's gonna happen and you know, someone's creeping, but again, just no. The plant looks awkward. I don't know what those other accessories are. Don't know what that is. It looks like a skateboard and a TV remote, which is really random. The shelves, it's not random because, you know, it's where you organize your random things, but, you know, I'll let that slide. On to the next setup. Really? Really? A purple and blue color theme? You see that everywhere. You need to be innovative with the color. The setups that we're looking at so far, the use of mouse and keyboard is fine. You know, the plants look nice. The ultra wide curved monitor looks nice. Why a blue and purple theme? You see that on PyroCynical's channel, not on this piece of garbage. And the wire setup. You can see the wires. I don't appreciate it. And what is this random circle looking thing right next to the mouse pad? That's so random. Is that where you put your cup? What are you doing? Like playing video games and then you have coffee right next to you? Who plays video games with coffee? I don't know anyone who would do that, but that is the silliest and dumbest idea that I've ever heard. That is so dumb. And the chair is horrible. This setup had so much potential. On top of that, what is this chair? So far, what we're looking at, all of these chairs, they're just terrible choices. Mouse, it looks like something familiar, but literally, the choice of the keyboard? What kind of blue LED light is that? Looks so weird. Listen, I appreciate your gaming case, but what is behind the monitor? What is this crinkly paper texture? What does that have anything to contribute with the setup? That's not fitting. That's so weird and random. Like, wouldn't want that on my setup. And in order to make the setup more appealing, change the color of the desk. It should be white. To match everything that you have with this black and white theme, I think white is the perfect color. Like you have the black mouse pad over the white desk, amazing. Or you could go with a straight black because then you have like this white computer case. But honestly, you need to change the desk. You need to change that crinkly paper weird looking setup. It makes me uncomfortable. It's hard to look at. Okay, I've got to admit that I like this whole clean setup, except explain the wires, bro. explain the wires. Towards the left side of the desk, you see the wires going everywhere. Where is that going and where is that connecting? Is it supposed to connect to the laptop? Are you hooking up like this very professional grade, which I can assume because I'm not familiar with this, headphones, to a laptop? Who hooks up their headphones to their laptop when you have this proper, amazing gaming monitor? You can listen to the best songs and get the best out of sounds from your computer. Why are you going for a laptop? I use my headphones on my laptop when I have to edit on the go. I don't just use my headphones when I'm just listening casually to music on this laptop. Who does that, bro? You have a desktop right in front of you. Why are you doing this to yourself? I'm very upset at you. But other than that, it looks pretty nice. I would try and color the edges of the table to like black because it's just kind of weird to look at this, you know, I guess birch color wood and then, you know, there's black on the top. It just looks really, really weird. But you know, I'm fine with the setup. Let's look at the next one. This is the last one, and I've got to appreciate that I love this setup. This is the setup that I would want in my house, because you have all sorts of themes. Like, I just love the fact that he has this like car poster, and then he has like pictures of cars in a frame. It's just more of a room style, and on top of that, it's a gaming style, which is the type of mood you want in your house. It's a proper room. On top of that, it's a proper gaming setup. It has a feel where, you know, you feel more relaxed, and I appreciate it a lot. There's not a lot of cons I can give, except for the fact that he messed up the bed, which is what happened in the last video. My bed was not exactly in the goodest shape. I'm sorry. I guess a lot of you guys can argue about the monitors, but I frankly appreciate that there's like a TV on the top, and then he tries his best to cover the wires so that way you don't have to see it. And I feel like that's the best he can do. Like, he could do a lot better, but that takes a lot of work, and you have to go inside the wall and then put the wires there, and you honestly don't want to spend time destroying a wall just to put wires in. It's not worth it. He has a small monitor next to an ultra wide monitor, but I've got to appreciate it because, you know, again, he's using a good space of whatever he's trying to do. Like, he has maybe like gaming stuff here, and then he's doing some Photoshop there, and then on TV he's like probably watching Netflix and stuff. So that's actually pretty cool. And I've got to admit that, you know, he could watch movies and stuff, and at least with this, you deserve to put a coffee cup there. With other setups, it doesn't feel right to have a coffee right next to your setup because it doesn't feel like a room. But with this, it's where you're like, yes, this is the setup where it feels like home. At the same time, it feels like an office space. And I've got to appreciate this setup. I know I'm taking too long to talk about the setup. I really, really appreciate it, especially the chair. It really stands out. I like the white and blue color. There's a lot of color themes in this, and I've got to appreciate it. There's not much cons to say about this, like I said. And I love the fact that the way the speaker, the color of the speakers, it really matches with the desk. Everything in a way matches each other, and you know, I would love to have a setup like this. It looks really nice. So that's it for Rate Your Gaming Setup episode 3. I know you guys love this series. I mean, seriously, the comments are very supportive. I mean, seriously, you guys want me to do a gaming setup, but I guess we'll see where that takes me. I don't know if I'm gonna do one, but if you guys give me at least 50 comments on making a gaming setup, then I guess I will do it. Even though I really don't want to do it, but I will do it. So let's see if you guys can do it. I'm pretty sure we can do it, but I really don't want to do it. So yeah, peace out, Home Slicers. More cringe coming soon.